Hello, everyone. Scott Roberts here with Explore Scientific and the Explore Now series of talks. Scheduled for today was Doug Grove from the Cherry Spring Star Party. And as we got about an hour before the scheduled talk today, he gave me a phone call. There was an emergency. Apparently, a pipe burst in his house, and he had to get the plumber and all the rest of it. So I reached out to John Johnson, who I talked to a little bit earlier, who's with me right now. John, how are you?
I'm fine.
So John came in like Superman, swooped in, okay, and saved the day. But John and I were talking earlier about the Nebraska Star Party, which is still scheduled to happen this July. And so when a lot of the events, Star Party events in the United States have canceled and around the world, I've been involved in several conversations about how do we do this, how do we safely observe and all the rest of it. But John, before we get really started here, why don't you talk a little bit, give a little introduction to some people that may not have ever met you, and a little bit about the Nebraska Star Party itself.
Okay, thanks, Scott. Well, like I said, it was a good excuse not to go out and do yard work, so I'm here and enjoying it. I've been an active amateur astronomer for, well, you can see by looking at me, at least 50 plus years. The last 20 or 25, I've been very active with the astronomy organizations around here in Omaha, Nebraska. I've been involved with the Omaha Astronomical Society for at least 25, 30 years, and I've been involved with the Nebraska Star Party organization since within about 2 years of its inception back in 1994. This will be our 27th year, currently I've been involved as the Director of Promotions and Outreach for the group.
Oh, great. That's great. So in our conversation, I've been to the Nebraska Star Party a couple of times. It's been a few years now since Explore Scientific was last there. We were there, 3 years ago, something like that?
I think it was, 3 years ago.
Right. And so and it's a fantastic, really dark Star Party. This is out in the Sandy Hills region of Nebraska, and there's not nary a light anywhere. You can see blackness all the way down the horizon. What you might think of as light pollution is actually what the Gegenschein or whatever, the light, the glow off of our own solar system. So
amazing. That we're not all that far north, but that time of year we'll even get faint air glow from over the poles that confound us. But that's it. That's all the light we have up there.
Right. And this is how many years of running this Star Party?
This will be our 27th annual Star Party. The first one. The first one was in 1994. There was a group of some of the amateurs from the Lincoln Astronomy or the club in Lincoln called the Prairie Astronomy Club. In fact, two or three of those gentlemen were kind of the instigators of the whole idea. I was not even aware of that first one, but I've been to everyone since except two others in the entire 27 years. So.
Wow. Okay. So you have maybe another way to show people some of the Star Party. Why don't you bring your web browser up full screen?
Want me to bring up full screen then? Okay.
Yeah, bring that up full screen. There you go. And now you can see the website itself. They've got a nice rotation of images there. What features? How would you describe the Nebraska Star Party to people that attend?
Well, in this age, no one even knew the word or what the word meant. But we've been social distancing for years up there. We have an area There, I'll see if I can lock this in. That area is the main area where we observe
Oh,
from,
yeah.
and you can see how spread out people are because we
Yes.
have an amazing amount of property there that the Nebraskan Game and Parks people bring in their mowers and mow it all off, so it's all the grass is all short. We sit right next to what's called the Merritt Reservoir there, so the beautiful lake behind us. There's a picture of near nightfall of some of the big scopes that gather up there.
Yeah, that might have to be more social distance than
Yeah,
that particular
we're
one.
already making plans to that, yeah.
Okay, all right. Right, and some nice scopes they had back then.
Yeah. There's a maybe slightly enhanced
Oh yeah,
view of the
but you get a
building from
feel. I
the
mean, look at this long exposure shot here. You get a feel for how dark this is. You're going to see the Milky Way all the way down to the horizon. It's a dream for a lot of deep sky observers. Astrophotographers love this area. There's actually kind of a separate place for where a lot of the astrophotographers would set up, but I noticed that all of them are very separated as well.
So with the advent of astroimaging really catching on, we've separated them so they don't bother us and we don't bother them, and
Right.
they have their own little area because, like I
Right.
said, we have so much property up there. We have probably at least 30 acres mowed off that we can set up, and spread out on.
Okay. So I know that you guys have had some conversations already about how do you conduct a star party, okay, with under this pandemic threat, where let's first off, I guess, just talk about the state of Nebraska. What is the situation in Nebraska with coronavirus?
Well, it's I think we're not quite as well off as you are down there in Arkansas, but the we haven't been under a lockdown, the governor mandated lockdown at all, although they're encouraging all the usual take precautions, don't be out unless you really need to go somewhere. Now you pretty well see everybody wearing a face mask.
Yeah.
When you go to the grocery stores or to the big box, stores like, Home Depot and Lowe's and Menards and whatever, but I think, we're handling it pretty well up here. The areas that did see quite a jump or bump in cases was, of course, the we have quite a few beef and poultry and pork processing plants, and
Yeah.
those are the ones that kind of took the hit up here. But all in all, the state's doing pretty well. Currently, the guidelines that have trickled down through the Nebraska Game and Parks is they, until the end of this month for sure, they didn't want anybody camping, tent camping, and like we do up there. And their main rationale is the people that camp like that out there in the open or within tents like to freshen up every day and, of course, go to the public showers and restrooms. And they're real hesitant yet to let people into those. I'm hoping that we'll get a relaxation of those maybe come the 1st of June or maybe the middle of June. Because that's going to be key to whether we actually feel we can hold the Star Party. Because I would say at least 50% of the people that show up there to observe and take in the activities are there. Oh, yeah, they camp or set up either on the field or one of the designated campsites.
Tent
Now the
camp,
state
maybe.
is, go ahead,
You
Scott. Yeah.
say that they camp like tent camping, right?
Correct.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
And reading the way I read it right now, say, I mean, you see in this picture, if you still have it up, people
No,
will
we
pull
go.
up their little pop-up campers there. I don't know if it'll stay there
We
or
go.
not.
Yeah.
They're not even encouraging that or want to see the pop-up campers out there like that because there again, you don't have the facilities to for sanitation and everything. The now they are allowing self-contained RVs
Sure.
and campers that have where you can hook up to the sanitary systems, and some of the campsites, even at Merritt, do have those facilities, plus they have a dump station. So they are allowing lake, but the key thing we're still trying to get resolved is the tent camping part of it. So that'll be, you know, the main decision that we'll have to make then.
Right. We got, let me pause here for just a moment to recognize some of the people that have joined us today. We have Ed Gunther, who I got to meet at the Arizona Dark Sky Star Party. Great guy. Dusty Haskins, also a great astrophotographer. He's joining us. Tyler S.E. Gusick. Okay, he says, hello, John.
Yeah, Tyler's one of ours.
Yeah, and Bob Wenzel is also joining us here.
Yeah.
Bob cautioned, he says, stay away from Grand Island. And
yeah.
He says, by the time of the Star Party, we should be good. Is that, do you think that is wishful thinking? How much is hoping and wishing that everything is going to be okay by June or July versus what you guys really think is going to be good?
I think there's still a lot of hoping and wishing that they'll relax that requirement. I think everything else we can probably work with. We've already, in our planning committee meetings, we've already talked about setting up, where people will have hand sanitizers. And obviously, you know, that main area, we have an area up there that is ideal for the general people that show up and want to observe through the large telescopes there. It's a large hard surface area about the size of a football field.
Yeah.
Maybe half a football field. But anyway, we've talked about we're just going to have to make sure people spread out. We figure we'll probably still be under the guideline to wear a safety, a face mask. We've talked about having people that, that have to have the large scopes where you have to climb up a ladder, having hand wipes there to wipe down the ladder. We'll have to have some rules, kind of like we do at a lot of outreach activities. Don't touch the telescope. I'm sure you've heard that.
And oh, yeah.
I've said that
sure,
many times.
Sure, sure, yeah.
Don't
that's,
touch the telescope.
That's a normal thing. It's because you can push the telescope off the object pretty easily.
Right.
So
but there'll be other
if it's a bigger scope. I mean, these guys know how to repoint a telescope. That's for sure.
Because of the,
But I had a conversation with someone in Spain who they had a situation where a hotel, hotels have been absolutely hammered, in this the coronavirus pandemic, and this particular hotel is in a dark sky location, and so they want to offer their guests an astronomy experience, for free. Some hotels, do this. I've been to several of them, especially some of these luxury hotels will offer a stargazing experience for their guests. But they were trying to figure out ways that they could do this safely. And I pointed out to them that the eyepieces that they sell Explore Scientific eyepieces, are waterproof. Now we have a line of them that are fairly inexpensive. And so we were talking about how many people would be there. Most of these people would not have their own astronomy gear, so they would set up telescopes for them to look through. I recommended a couple of things. One was is that if they wanted them to actually look through the eyepiece and get a visual experience, that they could sterilize these eyepieces, because they could just be doused in alcohol, cleaned off, because again they're waterproof. Put them in a sealed plastic baggie that would be given to the person that's going to do the observation, and that's their eyepiece for the night. Okay.
Oh, that's, I like that.
That's their eyepiece for the night. They're not
Okay.
sharing an eye cup with somebody else, okay, or whatever. So that's just what, and I recommended that they still kept the, they have a line going up to a telescope, that they have social distancing, and there would still have to be someone to tell them where to put the eyepiece, but you could do things like put glow-in-the-dark tape around where the eyepiece holder is, and that's where you slide in the eyepiece, and then you look down, and they'll have to also be taught how to focus and that kind of thing. But and then probably, a sanitation wipe of the focus knob or something like that. But they take their eyepiece with them. When they're done, I'm recommended that they just put them in a tub of lens cleaning solution, okay, and they can just submerge it and leave it there. And then when they're all gone, they can clean the eyepieces. So, and that would be sanitized. Okay. The other thing I recommended was, and you've seen people do this, John, is video astronomy, where they have the moon or a planet or something like that, and they're projecting the image up onto screens. But it is absolutely not the same experience as seeing something live, seeing it yourself, that kind of thing. But those are some ideas that have come about here. We have this show has been joined by Gary Palmer. He's watching now from the UK. Gary is a great astrophotographer, icon of outreach out there. Bob Wenzel wants to know from you, what about the meals?
Okay, good question. Yeah, I was already thinking that. Preliminary word is that the knowledge or the cater will be willing to come out if we get the numbers. And of course, that's one of the issues too, is are people going to be comfortable coming out there? We're hoping that's the case. Right now we have about 50 pre-registered people, but what we figure we'll do for the caterers, if they're up to this, and of course they'll have the final say, is we will probably have them do all the food, well, they do all the food preparation, but we typically we do it kind of like buffet style, where you grab a plate and you go through the line, and they give you a hamburger or a spoonful of potato salad or fruit or whatever we have.
Sure.
We may have to have them just doing all of that work themselves. And then at the end of the line, or we'll probably have to spread out the lines. At the end of the lines, we'll just have them already sitting there. Probably, we were talking about maybe probably in an extra expense we will have to absorb, but maybe like the containers you get when you leave a restaurant with the extra food you didn't need, with covers and everything. So we're kicking around ideas like between the food servers and the people, getting the food, the attendees. But that was one thought we had.
Okay. Well, it's for those of you that are watching, if you have any experience
Yeah,
doing
got any
some
ideas?
stargazing right now during this pandemic, what are your thoughts out there? Go ahead and write them down. We'll read them off and discuss that. This guy Bergman Scooters has just got in. Which star party is he speaking of? We are talking about the Nebraska Star Party, which is located outside of Valentine, Nebraska, in the Sandy Hills region out there, correct?
Yes, North Central Nebraska.
Right. And so it is a very remote spot. This particular star party is on a big area. How many acres are out at the stargazing site?
Okay, I dropped sync there, but
No,
the
I was just,
entire
yeah,
park
how
is
many
huge.
acres are out there? We're having a little bit of signal.
Yeah. The areas, as I said before, the areas that we set up the scopes and everything, it's called the Snake Campground. There's various campgrounds designated out there. And I would say we have typically 20 to 30 acres of land that's the grass is all mowed down, so you don't have to worry about tall grass or anything, and you can drive your vehicle out on it without any problems. So there's plenty of property there to set up on.
Sure. Okay, well, your Star Party also has speakers.
Generally. Correct.
Speakers, you have door prizes, so you have that kind of event. What do you guys envision this looking like when you set up?
Well,
do we have chairs
that's
that
the other area.
Really far apart? And
that's the other area. Yeah, the other area that is a major concern, and we're waiting for a decision, is that typically the week we're up there, we take the middle day, which is usually Wednesday.
Yeah.
And we go into Valentine, into town. It's about a 30, 35-minute drive, or, you know, into town to Valentine, to the northeast. And we congregate at the Valentine High School, which is a very nice facility. They have a beautiful air-conditioned, theater-style seat auditorium that we hold the lectures and talks in, and the door prizes. We also have an astrophotography contest. And vendors there and swap meets. And that is still another big question.
Yeah.
We don't feel that could be, eliminated without totally eliminating the Star Party. We're thinking about some contingencies there. And one of them might be just to try to hold some kind of speaker event out at the site, but probably. And where we actually have the observing field, we've talked about putting up additional tents. I've already visited with our tent rental people, and they would have no problem bringing up a couple additional tents to set up. Maybe in a shady area where we could, and protect us from the wind. Because, the good thing about the site is we have a clear horizon for 360 degrees.
Right.
The bad thing about the site is you're out there in the open, subject to whatever elements may come through.
That's true. That's true.
Building up. So, it's kind of a double-edged sword there. So we're talking maybe possibly if the high school says, no way, we can't use the facility, then maybe we will get another big tent to set up and just try to have to do daytime talks in a shady area or something.
Okay. So Gary Palmer chimed in. He says parts of the UK are still on lockdown, so we're still waiting for that to lift before any events are looked at. And that's true in many areas of the United States. Doug Grove, who was going to be on the show today, was talking about the decision of the Cherry Spring Star Party of shutting down. And, before we were going to go on, before the pipes bust in his house, he was mentioning it's strange because county by county within the state are having different rules applied to them on social distancing and lockdown scenarios that are going on. And the good thing about the Star Party site where Cherry Springs is held at is actually under less lockdown than a lot of the rest of the state. And so, and probably just because of where it is, but they said that their problem was bathrooms, I think that's a problem with a lot of areas that are going on. I did bring my Airstream up to Nebraska Star Party. They do have nice hookups and all the rest of that. And I think that, is it possible? I mean, if you got like a main unit, can you bring it up to the observing field itself?
Yes. As the rules, as I understand them right now, and those of you from Nebraska that are listening in, correct me if I'm wrong. First of all, it's a blanket all over the state. They haven't split up, the state into certain areas, and I'll maybe touch on that in a little second. But is that you can bring in and you can stay overnight in self-contained RVs either the type that where you store any black water on your vehicle or unit
yeah.
itself, and then go to the dump stations. The dump stations are open, or some of the larger parks down in the eastern end of the state, I know, have full facilities where you can hook right up to water and sewer with your RV. So they're allowing that. But as I said before, the main issue that is still would be holding us up is the idea of being able to tent camp and use the shower facilities. Now, maybe some kind of common ground, or we can get down to a county by county area, because let's face it, you get out, and that's one of the reasons we have the Star Party out there. There is just very few people. And Cherry County is where this is at, in north central Nebraska. That county is bigger than the state of Connecticut.
Oh,
and
geez. That's a big county.
And as the last time I checked, and I don't want to jinx them, they had had only like one or two of coronavirus. So
I see.
Maybe there's some wiggle room there. Another area that I know is under pressure to open up is out in the western end of the state. The largest lake or reservoir in Nebraska is called Lake McConaughey. It's a huge recreational facility. It's actually closer to people coming out of Colorado than most of people in Nebraska. So they get a huge amount of people that drive up from the Colorado, Denver, Boulder area to Lake McConaughey. And I personally know the person that is the park superintendent out there for Lake McConaughey, and they don't know. They are just hoping they can come up with some kind of things, because they I don't know how they're going to be able to handle the crowds if they don't open up and let them, because that lake has a lot of sandy beaches and everything that people like to go out and camp on and everything.
So. Oh, yeah.
We'll see. Hopefully we can get some relaxation.
Yep. So Paul Surowick is writing in here, and he says, our Michiana Club does a fair amount of outreach. We've had quite a bit of discussion about what we could do for health concerns and disinfecting equipment. One of the members, who is a retired doctor, said all you need is one person with their mask off to cough or sneeze to contaminate the whole area and blow away, literally blow away, all of our precautions. So that's how do you guys think that you can deal with this kind of an issue?
Well, I think we've already said we're probably going to mandate, if you're going to be around the telescopes, any of us, you're going to have your a decent face mask on. I think that's the very minimum.
We're still wearing them here at Explore Scientific. I go outside of my office, I've got this thing on. Or if somebody comes in my office, we're wearing them. And if
we even talked about the actual Nebraska Star Party organization purchasing some and have them there just in case, for people that don't bring them.
Absolutely. Absolutely.
Yeah. Got to.
Got to. Bergman Scooter says, I'm going to possibly gather up my Comet Hunter, thank you, and go by that way with my camper. I'll be coming from South Louisiana. Where can I get up-to-date information on this?
We will have it on our website. Once we know for sure, breaking news, Nebraska Star Party does have a Facebook site too. We'll try to keep that updated. The site, I don't know if I.
Yeah, what is the?
I don't have that
site address. It's www.nebraskastarparty.
That's our site. Yeah, just nebraskastarparty.org.
There we go.
There again, you can just Google or whatever engine you use, call up the Nebraska Game and Parks.
Yeah.
Have the latest information on what they're allowing at the parks. Now, I know they open things up a little bit through May here, but most the bigger parks on the eastern end of the state, they may have what we call the guard shack, people to go online and buy park permits ahead of time, because every Nebraska Game and Park site, you have to have a vehicle permit to go on the site. And then if you're staying overnight, well, if we allow the camping or even with the RVs, you have to have a daily park pass for the park you're in.
Okay. And what about generators, electrical power?
Well, obviously, if someone's coming in with a generator, we highly encourage them to use it judiciously. Most of us are up, into the wee hours of the morning. But then if you're out on the observing areas, you like to dive into your tent or your camper and get some sleep. So we try to encourage them not using generators, from the early in the morning till about noon, just so the people that want to try to get some sleep. Of course, many of the modern generators, you can hardly hear them anymore. They're getting very, very quiet.
But, right.
We don't, as a blanket rule, we do not allow them. We'll take each case as they come.
Yeah, they probably have to relax some of these kind of rules for this particular unusual circumstance, So, well, that's great. I don't know if anybody else has any of the questions here or there's anything that you'd like to say and to kind of wrap up. Is there anything that you lasting impression you want to leave with our viewers here, John?
Well, stay tuned. We'll get the word out as soon as we can. We have monthly planning meetings, and our next one is scheduled for June 11th. So that'll be probably the one where we say, yep, we're going to go, or no, we probably can't. So by the following, that's a Friday or Thursday, I think, so by the following Monday, I think the website said something about the 15th of June. We hope to have a good decision by then. There's quite a bit of groundwork that we're still trying to come up with. So we have a coherent policy. If we are allowed to hold the Star Party, then yes, we'll have to take the necessary precautions and be good stewards and not create an issue out there.
Sure. Okay. Well, we'll have to get you back on the show, John.
Okay.
To do a follow up, about Nebraska Star Party, coming up on Friday this week, we've got Jerry Hubble. He has a recent article published in Astronomy magazine about exoplanets and what the Mark Slade Remote Observatory has been doing. So he's going to be joining us. So if you're watching, you might be interested in that. His article is about how anyone, any backyard astronomer can do this precision, super precision, diffuse photometric method. And so they get down to measuring down to a thousandth of a magnitude by using this special, fairly inexpensive diffuser. So it's a remarkable thing, and it was a technique learned from professional astronomers. We have other shows coming up as well. There's still being, the dates are being firmed up, but Michael Bakich from Astronomy Magazine will be joining us as well. And so we'll have lots of other shows as we go along. If you have any comments or anything like that, or anything that you would like to see, you can email me at explorescientific.com. John, how do people get in touch with you if they have questions?
My personal email, well, I'll give it out now,
we need your bank account, your personal email,
the personal email,
your social security.
Well, I'll tell you what, if you go to the Nebraska Star Party page, the website, nebraskastarparty.org, under one of the tabs, there's a link for an email that you can send an email, and that translates to my personal email, and you can ask any questions. And like I said, we'll try to keep that updated and keep everybody informed. I highly recommend you go there. And we didn't get a chance because we couldn't get the sound to work. But at near the bottom of the main page is our video that I highly recommend you. Well, that was last year, the NSP trailer. Good promo for Explore Scientific there, too.
Oh, well, thank you.
Yes, because a good part of that had some footage of Scott with his display set up there and everybody crowding around looking at all those fine telescopes you produced then.
Yeah, well, thank you very much. You guys are so good to us. Well, we're, you know, Explore Scientific, of course, is there to help support you guys in any way that we can, you know, so... but we do want people to be safe out there. It's been great that you shared this time with us, John, and also for saving, you know, swooping in and saving the day for our program today. But again, the group, you know, one of the things I would like to say about the group of the Nebraska Star Party is you guys are, you know, the best of your kind. So, you know, it's very friendly, very accommodating. The last time I was at Nebraska Star Party, I get the Star Party names mixed up sometimes. I saw people out there with their kids with like 60 millimeter refractors, little ones, you know, but you know, what can a 60 millimeter refractor do under the most incredibly dark skies that there are? They could do a lot, actually.
You'd be surprised. Yes.
They were finding deep sky objects. They were finding star clusters. So it's, you know, it makes every telescope just really work much, much better, you know, because of the transparency and the light pollution levels that are protected and maintained there. So, you know, and light pollution and you guys are getting close, I think, to having dark sky status.
Yes, we're working very closely with the Nebraska Tourism Commission, who jumped on board and been super supportive with helping us with the get the designation from the International Dark Sky Association. We are right in the midst of working with through them and the Game and Parks organization. We've identified necessary lighting that has to be replaced. Everybody's on board with that, and that will probably happen this summer. There's some other, obviously, all the little hoops you have to go through to document the sky conditions and everything up there. We were all set to do it last summer, and unfortunately, the two or three nights that we had it designated to happen was cloudy. Oh. So that's another reason I say if you're going to, if not more, because we do get the occasional thunderstorm that comes through and it'll dark you out. But what's interesting, if you haven't been out in really dark skies, and if you've lived around light polluted areas, you know, when you look up at night, when you go out in a light polluted environment, the clouds look white, right?
Yeah.
You go up there.
They look black. The clouds look black.
No light reflecting off.
That's right. Yeah. That's right. They're just like, why is the sky darker there? You know, if it couldn't possibly get any darker, you know, it's super dark. Yeah. So,
yeah,
that's right.
It really does throw some people because they think, oh, well, what is that? Because they're used to seeing the light from the cities reflect off the clouds and they can see them.
And the other thing they say is where are my familiar constellations? They just get absolutely lost in the stars, you know? So
you get lost.
Oh, my God.
Well, and the other thing one other thing we brag about, and we prove it. It's so dark up there, your eyes get dark adapted, and the Milky Way casts a shadow.
It does.
Yeah,
that's a fact. That is a fact. It's fun to take like a card or something, you know, against like a white piece of paper or something. You can actually see the shadow, and it's just the light from the Milky Way. So, if you haven't seen that, guys, you got to at least get that on your bucket list. So
get out there.
Yep.
Get out there.
Well,
and we're already planning for next year. If this one doesn't happen, we've set the dates for next year.
Yeah.
Just if you want to mark your 2021 calendar, It'll be a little later. It'll be from the 1st of August through, I think, whatever that is, that Friday, the 5th or 6th.
Mm-hmm.
So if you can't make it this year, we're already planning for next year.
Sure, sure. All right. Well, thanks very much, John. And we will
thank you, Scott.
We'll be talking
really
to you later.
It.
You guys check back in. I'll be sending out announcements for upcoming talks. Take care and keep looking up.
Thank you. Keep looking up. All right.